All right, guys, welcome to episode 144 of Dope Talk TV. It's yours truly, Low Key. Got John here with me, and we're back with another one. We appreciate everybody that's rocking, liking, sharing, subscribing. Don't forget to do just that. You know what I'm saying? Share it with a friend. Post it somewhere. Go down in the description. Get yourself a little merch if you haven't done so already. And if you have, love and appreciation. You know what I'm saying? But we're back with another one. It's a beautiful Tuesday. How we feeling, Johnny? How we feeling? How we feeling?
Shit. To be honest, I'm feeling good, man. I'm kind of tired, though. Had a long fucking week, but, you know.
Well, there goes the no cursing. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Damn,
like,
bro.
I'm trying to tell this guy, bro. I'm like, yo, let's clean it up a little bit. Let's not curse as much. You know what I'm saying? Let's keep that for the Patreon viewers.
I don't realize
it. And it's like,
it.
Bro, like.
I don't realize how much I be cursing sometimes.
Yeah, bro. It's a lot. It's excessive with us sometimes. You know what I'm saying?
So like a sailor. Yeah, Jesus.
Bro. But yeah, man, it's a beautiful Tuesday, bro. You had it, you know, you had a little long weekend. You had a nice little event, nice little vibe going on, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it was a good time. You know, we had a little condo and shit like that. You know what I mean? Chilled. Good vibe, bro. You know, I did my music video. It's going to come out pretty soon. Hopefully the end of this year, like the end of this month.
Round of applause to that, man. Round of applause to my dog working, man. You got to stay doing something, bro. You got to stay working.
Yeah,
you
know what I mean? It was productive.
Yeah, it wasn't just like a chill. Like, it was a chill night, but it wasn't just that, bro. It was work, though.
You might as well have something after if, you know, you're going to have the empty space anyways. You know what I mean? Let me bring all my homies and all my homegirls together, and let's just have a good time.
Yeah, it was a good time, bro. I was sipping on some fine wine. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Shorties around, bro. It was a good vibe.
There was more women than guys, you know? I'm not going to lie, guys.
Yeah, bro. We got to take it back to those times, man. Because I don't know, bro. It's weird. Like, nowadays, bro, like, a lot of people show up to parties, and there's more guys than girls. And it's like, bro, like.
Yeah, like, if it's a girl party and a girl host, then she wants guys there. You know what I mean? But if it's, like, you know, like me, like a guy that's hosting it, I want girls. I want more women.
Man, it's not even, like. Women are gonna bring the guys.
Regardless.
You always want girls there. The guys are gonna come. If the women are there, the guys are there. You
know that's true.
It's just simple mathematics.
That's true.
For real. But simple mathematics, man. Talking about simple mathematics, oh, right? God. They say that everybody has a price. Everybody has a price, right?
Yeah.
So, how much do you need in your bank account to let a man fuck your wife?
Man, to be honest with you, bro.
Like, if she was down with it, of course.
Like, you're gonna, like, I need at least $500,000.
Damn. He said he going cheap.
Yeah, $500,000. Because you know what I could do with that
$500,000? Fucking lying. I need $1 billion.
Nah, right.
That nigga come to you with 20 racks, bro. Yeah. Like, baby, we can get a new car. Yeah. We can get out the loan.
For real, we can get out the house mortgage. That's all we owe is 20 grand, you know? Nah, it's true, though, man. Like, people would be fronting to be like, $1 billion.
Yeah, man. It's like, bro, listen, man. There's people that be flexing. It's like, bro, if somebody came to both of y'all with the right price, you're both knowing it.
There's people that do that shit. They walk up to random people and record it, and they're like, hey, I have a briefcase full of $1 million. You let me bang your wife?
Yeah.
And they really think about
it. Yeah,
they
be like,
but like, baby.
And the girl be getting mad. Yeah. It's like, listen, man, $1 million is $1 million.
A million is a million, baby. And you know what we could do with that? I'm telling you.
It's for the better good of both of us.
I swear. Nah, but some people don't care about that, though. Some people really say no.
Yeah, no, facts.
Like, I mean, some people have morals and shit. Yeah, like, you know?
Like, honestly, but is it, like I said, bro, how much? Everybody got a price.
No, I'm going to say about either $500,000.
Well, no, so you come with a $500,000, bro. It's a wrap.
Yeah, you come with $500,000. I'll take on.
He said, I'll fucking drop off.
Shit, I'll fuck it for you. No, I'm kidding. No, but that's interesting, bro. I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't know what I would do, bro. You know, money talks, man.
Yeah, no, money talks, bro. People flex, people front, people lie, but money talks, bro. Like I said, there's couples out there right now that are like, I would never. And then somebody comes to you with a real offer and is like, damn, we can make a quick $100,000. There's more people that'll do it for that amount than what they think. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real.
I don't know. So, like, do I have to watch you bang her? Like, how does that work?
No, bro,
like,
he just wants to bang her. He's like, bro, you drop her off, I'll bring her back in the morning.
Okay.
Here's $250,000.
Yeah. I mean, shit, that's fine. Just drop her off at this address.
He's like, just drop off where I left her.
Yeah.
And that's it. I'm at $250,000 in that account.
Yeah, 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 exactly.
Wire. Wire it over.
You know what I don't get, though?
What's that?
I don't know, man. I don't know why women do this sometimes, but we were talking about sex, so I don't know. I'm just going to throw this out here real quick. Fucking, basically, bro, I've been in a situation where it was just, this was recent, and it was weird. It was just like, I'm not going to fuck you, but I'm going to give you head.
That's cool.
I know, I was fine with it, but it was just like, but what's the difference at the end of the day?
I mean, she ain't giving up the pussy. There's a big difference.
You think so?
Yeah. I think so.
That's interesting. You know, it's just like, I really think it's not the same thing. It's not, obviously. But.
Right.
Yeah, I'm still inside you.
Yeah, but it's not. It's just, it's different, man.
Yeah?
It's different. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I don't know.
I feel like I enjoy, if your head is really good, I'll enjoy it more than.
Bro,
more than
men that. Don't give a fuck, bro. Most men don't give a fuck if it's a fucking blowjob, if it's a hand job, if it's the cooch. We don't give a fuck. As long as we bust our nut. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, like, for real. That's most guys. I said, that's fine. Like, I was actually pretty happy. I just got to sit there and not do anything.
There's times where I just prefer the neck.
Yeah,
because it's like, if I like,
that's what I'm saying. Not,
like, if I have to hit now, then there's a lot of more work I have to put in.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly.
Get your dicks like it. Just you just
lay,
your dicks
just
up.
Fucking lay back, you and you mean? Fucking but, let her do the show.
Yeah,
like, you know what I mean? Yeah, but that was funny.
Yeah, there's a difference. There's a difference. Ladies, go down in the comments and let us know.
You know,
if y'all think there's a difference. If you don't, whatever.
Giving
y'all
head and giving it up. Know. You know?
Yeah, that's a fact.
That's crazy. But,
yeah, bro. You know what's fucking crazy is this woman marries herself and then divorces herself 3 months later. Round of applause, bro.
Get the hell that out right of there. Here. Just,
yeah, no, she really like married herself and then divorced herself.
Oh my gosh!
At 3 months, that's all it took for her to find out she wasn't shit.
No, it took her 3 months to realize that
she wasn't shit.
Nah,
wow, like I ain't shit, bro.
Yeah, like you know, you just.
I don't even like myself.
Myself. I don't even want to see myself in the mirror. I wake up and it's like, yo, when are you going to get out of my face?
What the fuck, bro? Every day I got to be with you.
Nah. That's weird, though. That's a weird thing to do.
It's just, first of all, marrying yourself itself is pretty dumb.
Is that even possible for real?
I'm pretty sure there's ways you can marry yourself. Niggas have married goats and like toasters and all. Bro, you can literally marry whatever you want.
Yeah.
It's the craziest thing. But it just goes to show, man. Women, you can't even stand yourself. You couldn't stand yourself for longer than you know what I'm saying?
Oh, it was a woman that married herself. Okay, I'm sorry. I thought it was a man the whole time. I'm sorry, bro.
This guy don't listen. Yeah. He came in here still drunk, chewing gum all in the fucking microphone. He don't give a fuck about nothing
today. I'm sorry, guys. Fuck, man. But yeah, bro, that's crazy, man. Fucking a girl, bro, marrying herself. She must have been tired of herself for real. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, that just, like I was saying, that just goes to show women don't know what they want. Women don't know what they want. They want this, they want that. Oh, I'm better than that. We don't need a man, but then we do. I'm going to marry myself and divorce myself. It's like, bro, like, y'all figure it out. And then you let us know.
Yo, figure it out, bro. It was kind of like that fucking guy that married his fucking carnival ride. It was like one of the first carnival rides, and he fell in love with it, so he married it.
Dumbass.
And I was just like,
that's stupid, bro. Like,
he's like, yeah, I have to come see it every other day. We sit down for hours, and you know, I just sit there
and
rub it.
Talk to the fucking metal.
Yeah, that's what
that
it was.
Is insane. Like, there's a special place for you in the mental ward, bro. I feel like if you're doing stuff like that, it's like, bro, you need to go talk to a psychiatrist, and they need to really figure out what the root of your trauma is, because there's something wrong. There's something wrong, bro.
You know, I'm starting to realize that mental health is really, really, really serious, you know? And a lot of people don't even fucking realize it.
Yeah, mental health is a serious thing, man. And the craziest part about it is, like, suicide rates are 3 times higher amongst men than amongst women. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, we hold a lot of shit in as men, bro. Like, we hold a lot of shit in, bro. We're taught as little kids, you don't cry like a little girl. You don't do this. You don't do that. You don't show emotion. Like, you just, you deal with it on your own. And I feel like that has a lot to do with why men kill themselves three times more than women.
Yeah, like us guys will be like, oh, toughen up, man.
Yeah, no, toughen up, bro. There's certain, I'm telling you, bro, we've mentioned it before, bro. Like, something as simple as a breakup. Your homeboys will make fun of you for being a bitch about it.
For real.
But it, I kind of agree. It's like, bro, toughen up. But that's what we tell each other. It's like, bro, like, hoes are hoes. You'll find another this or whatever the fuck you tell each other. We tell each other shit that's like, you're pretty much just dismissive. Like, it's being dismissive, bro. And it's like, bro, we're all human. We all got feelings, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it's like, as men, we do it to each other a lot. And then women, it's like, most women, they're like, bro, I don't want to see you fucking, like, crying. And it's like, bro, like, bitch, fuck you. You cry.
Yeah.
Like, somebody in my family just died.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, that's way different.
Yeah, nah, I'm not talking about the crybaby-ass niggas that be crying for fucking every little thing. I'm talking about, like, but there's women that, like there's people I've known that they got made fun of type shit for being sensitive about situations like that. And it's, that comes from, as a man, as a boy, you're not supposed to be fucking showing emotion. You know what I mean? And it's like, I feel like it's time for that shit to stop, bro. Like, bro,
yeah, like, yo,
men got feelings too, bro.
Yeah,
as much as, like, you niggas don't want to fucking show her, you want to deny it, whatever the fuck, men have feelings too.
Yeah, like that, bro. It's always those guys that, I'm the toughest guy around. Like, bro, like, some women like when you fucking show a little bit of emotion too. Like, you show some type of, like, you know.
Yeah, bro, like, just, man, there's a time and a place for everything. There's a time and a place to be tough. There's a time and a place to be fucking, you know, be heartfelt. And there's a time and a place. Like, there's just, there's different times and places for different things, bro.
Exactly.
And you can't be, like, gang banging on breakfast, like Cat Williams likes to say. He's like, bro, there's niggas that wake up and they gang bang on their breakfast. Like, like, my nigga, like, just, come on, bro. Like, like, you that, you like that with your kids too? You fucking throwing up fucking gang signs and shit when they tell you they want to take a shit or something. It's like, bro, like, relax. Relax. Be a father. It's time. There's times to be a father. There's times to be a fucking gang member, if that's what you are. And there's times to be with your mom. You know what I'm saying? You can't be the same thing, you know?
Yeah.
Everywhere you go.
Everywhere you fucking go. I keep saying we're not going to freaking curse, and we keep fucking doing it. I'm sorry.
Yeah, bro. We'll work on it. We'll work on it over
time. I don't realize it. I need to stop. Yeah,
nah, you need to work on your vocabulary, bro. Yeah,
what the hell?
That's what that means. That means you don't have other words to fill in for the curse.
Beep. Nah, I'm just playing. Nah, but I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to get married soon, bro. How about you?
I don't know, man. I'm working on looking at somebody, you know, to marry.
Okay.
Yeah. Like,
oh, what the?
I'm looking to find a prospect.
We had a conversation about that too, bro. About how, like, yo, it's about that time, bro. You know, to, like,
really, nigga, I've been single a long time, and it's not just that. It's like, bro, time's flying. Parents are getting older. I've said it 1,000 times. My parents are older than most people's parents, 20 years older than most people's parents.
Yeah.
So they're getting to that age where it's like, bro, like, I want them to experience grandkids for me too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's
so
true.
So it's like, the hard part for me is just finding somebody that's compatible, bro. It's like, being pretty, being beautiful, having a good body, all that shit's cool, bro. But there's a lot more to like, starting to build, like, a family with somebody than just that. Like, so,
and I'm starting to realize that now, bro. You know, like, I'm around a lot of certain beautiful women, and it's just certain things that really throw me off. I just don't like it. Like, you know, like, if you're getting too drunk or you can't handle yourself, and I got to put you through different situations to see how you act. You know what I mean? Because it's like, if this is how you act when you're drunk, then it's like, we can't have that. You know what I mean? We can't go out and have a normal night. There's a lot of things you gotta, like, really look into when you really wanna, like, get with somebody and have kids and all this shit. So
yeah, bro, it's gotta be beyond just, like, how do you handle your liquor. It's like, bro, are you a responsible person? Yeah. Do you have morals and principles?
Exactly.
How do your fucking parents treat each other? Mm-hmm. Like, did you have both parents around? Is your dad a piece of shit? Do you have daddy issues?
You got mental,
like,
issues?
There's a lot of fucking different things that go into, like, because, bro, your child is half that. Think about it. They're half you and half them. So whatever traumas they're carrying, whatever bad toxic traits they're carrying and shit like that, bro. You don't want that to be passed on to your children. Mm-hmm. If their whole family's fucking crazy and every time they get together and it's a barbecue, niggas is throwing hands and fucking bottles is flying. It, like, bro, you don't, like, do you really want to step into a situation where your kid's going to grow up around that?
Nah, hell no.
You know what I'm saying? It's things like that, bro. Like you got to really, really fucking think about who you getting, who you having a kid with. And at this point in my life, it's like the marriage shit is cool. Like, yeah, a wife would be amazing, but that's not the ultimate goal for me. The ultimate goal is to find somebody, bro, that even if we're not together,
yeah,
like, we're going to raise this child right. Because it's like, it's cool, bro. Having that fairy tale fucking story, oh, we met, we fucking got married, we never got divorced, and we lived the rest of our lives together, that's great. If that happens, awesome. But life is life, bro. If we end up getting divorced in 5 years, I need to know that you're not the type of person that's going to be petty with my child, not letting me see my kid, taking me to court when you know I do everything. Like, because there's just too much that goes on with it, bro. So
yeah, nah,
you got to really think about it.
And we see friends go through it, too. I see other people that go through it with their, like, you know, their baby moms and stuff like that. I'm just like, oof, I'm so glad I dodged a bullet with certain people in the past. Because, like, I look at it and I'm like, wow, now, like everything does happen for a reason, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, you ever notice, like, certain things in life that happen? It's just like, wow, you know? Like, what are the chances? You know what I mean? It's wild. It's wild how life is, bro. Like, it's deep, bro, for real. It's a crazy shit.
Yeah, man. Shit happens. You can't really do too much about it, but just learn from it, and just keep going. But it's just life, man. It's just life. And I don't know why, bro. Nowadays, a part of life is these youngins, man, disrespecting the dead, bro. And I feel like it's time for some of us, like, I mean, we ain't that much older than these niggas, but it's like, bro, somebody has to tell these niggas, bro, stop doing that shit. It's not cool. Like, the music makes it sound so awesome to be smoking on Op Pack. And it's like, bro, first of all, let's just keep, bro, I'm going to be 1,000 right now. Bro, 98.9% of y'all don't have ops
at all.
You don't have ops, bro.
Like,
you fought somebody and y'all don't like each other. That's not a fucking op.
That's what it's called, like, nowadays.
No, but it's
that's
not, what they call bro. It. They're that's fucking what they dumb. Call it. They're dumb. Like, you're dumb. If you really think that, like, bro, that's not what that is. First of all, that's a Chicago term. People need to stop dick riding other places, bro. They need to stop dig riding in other places. Like, that's why I don't understand gang banging in Florida. It's like, what the fuck are you doing? Do you know that that's from all the way across the fucking nation?
Yeah. Like, it's
that
not
shit's
here.
Not from
this is
here.
A nice neighborhood.
In my opinion, anybody that's gang banging outside of California, you're imitating, bro.
Yeah.
You're an imitator. If you didn't get fucking blessed, if you didn't go out there and get put on in the land, nigga, you ain't a real blood or Crip or whatever the fuck it is you claim to be.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But I'm just tired of it, bro. Like, I listen to certain music and I'll always listen to it. It's part of our culture. It's part of what I grew up with, whatever. But, bro, like, niggas need to stop disrespecting the dead, bro.
Yeah, smoking on a pack, really? Like,
bro,
I don't understand
that shit. Like, back in the day, bro, even, like, the old school mob dudes and the old school gangsters, you know what I'm saying? Like, once somebody's gone, they're gone. Rest in peace.
Yeah.
Rest in peace.
Yeah, don't.
That's
don't,
it. Don't, that's it,
don't
bro.
Don't smoke on Op Pack and stuff like that. Like, an op is, like, literally somebody, like, trying to, like, murk you, too.
Bro, if y'all,
like,
ain't trying to kill each other every single time you see each other, it's not an op. Bro.
Yeah, on sight.
It's not an op. And even though, even niggas that are real ops, it's not on sight a lot of the time.
If you're with your family, you know.
Yeah, it's like, oh, that nigga's with his fucking girl. Give him a pass.
Like, you shouldn't. Like,
and that's how it should be.
No, that's how it should be, for real. Like, you, like, if somebody's with their kid and, you know, with their mom and you catch them lacking, like, I wouldn't even get near that. I wouldn't even look that way, because that's just disrespectful, you know. I wouldn't want nobody doing that to me or trying to fight me in front of my mom or in front of my grandma or my kid or try to do anything to harm me. You know?
Yeah, nah, bro. Like, it's just like, in my opinion, it's common sense. But again, man, guys, stop disrespecting the dead. Stop disrespecting the dead. A lot of you kids, bro, rhyming these rhymes and portraying a lifestyle that you've never been in, bro, are good kids.
Yeah,
a lot of y'all are good kids, bro. Be a good kid that grows up into a good person. Like, don't be somebody that ends up ruining your whole fucking life over nothing.
They're
just trying to prove something to people that you ain't even gonna be friends with 5 years from now. Like, there's people, think about that, bro. There's people sitting in prison for the rest of their life because they wanted to prove something to a group of people that in 7 to 10 years from that point, they wouldn't have even been talking to no more.
Yeah.
Like, and it's like, bro, like,
they don't care about you.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like even listen, people, bro, in gangs nowadays, bro. Like, you think this gang stuff is really like, come on, bro. Most of them are not holding it down for you. You know, bro, sometimes I'm going to
say something that's probably an unpopular opinion. I don't give a fuck. Whoever watches us at gangbangs, hit me up and let me know how you feel. But I feel like cowards running groups.
Yeah, me too.
Cowards running groups.
Me too.
And I feel like if I've said it before, if you're not from that life, if you're really not from like a certain neighborhood, like, because there's people that are born in situations where deadass, you're a Crip before you're born. Like, your mom's a Crip, your dad's a Crip, uncle's Crip, your cousins, everybody's Granddaddy. Crip. So by the time you're born, they threw you a Crip fucking, like, baby shower.
Yeah.
Like, that type of shit really happens.
Yeah.
If that's your situation, bro, like
dang, okay.
That's your situation.
That's your life.
But there's people like Chris Brown, bro. A nigga was already fucking a millionaire and in his 20s.
Now he's a blood.
He was multi-millionaire in his 20s. Now he's a blood. Same thing with fucking Soulja Boy.
Yeah.
He was, oh, we from the same hood. Nigga, neither one of y'all fucking grew up in California. You're not from that hood.
You think Lil Wayne's a blood?
No, bro. I don't feel like none of them niggas are really bloods, man.
Damn.
I feel like it's real bloods that see an opportunity to feed the gang. Okay. And they're like, oh, bro,
it's the moneymaker.
Yeah, if we let this nigga in, he's a cash cow, bro. Like the Tekashi shit. That's exactly what the Tekashi shit was, but it went left.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? That's exactly what it was. They're like, you know what? This kid's about a pop, bro. He's going to make us multimillionaires. We're going to be able to feed the gang.
Let's protect him.
Let's let him rock a red rag.
Yeah.
Who gives a fuck?
Let's rock. Yeah, let him rock it.
But that's the consequences of doing it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, other people are not going to like it.
You can't let everybody in. But I don't think that none of these guys went out there and put in no work to be no fucking blood.
And Shoddy,
I just don't see it.
The manager, his ex-manager, the one that was smashing his... you know, his baby mom the whole time. Yeah, allegedly. Yeah,
I don't believe it.
It wasn't true. Okay.
I don't know. Who knows? But I just don't. I personally don't believe it. I think that's just an excuse that Tekashi's using that's why I snitched. Like, nah, bro.
That's true.
Nah, deadass. That's how true. I feel.
I didn't think about that.
That's how I feel.
And you know what? Is like, he's down to like his last dollar, apparently. Like, there was like a meme that was going viral saying that he's still locked up and he's down to his last dollar. Like, he's broke.
That's coming how it from goes. Then. That's how it goes.
People are like, oh, you know, karma, you know, and a lot of people are on 6ix9ine's side. You know what I mean for this? And it's says a lot. It says a lot.
It says a lot. What it says to me is none of y'all niggas ever been in the street.
Exactly.
None of y'all niggas ever dealt with anybody really in the street.
Yeah.
And you've never fucking seen any real situation.
You're making it acceptable.
Like, it's acceptable where you're from.
Yeah.
Because guess what? 98% of his fucking fans are like white kids from the suburbs.
I'm a suburban.
So, of course, yeah, like Kodak, I'm a suburban kid. So, of course, bro, those kids don't see nothing wrong with snitching because in their lives, there ain't nothing wrong with snitching.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't understand that, bro, there's codes and ethics. And at the end of the day, bro, people are like, oh, well, you know, they try to kidnap him and this and that. And it's like, bro, that, like, once you jump in that fucking life,
That's what's going to come with it. Yeah, it's like if you do something bad and you start freaking robbing people and stuff like that, this is what's going to happen.
Bro, you're sending out hits. You're sending out hits online.
Yeah.
I got a 20-pack on his head. And niggas are really shooting at niggas once they see him. You're sending out real hits. You're doing real mob shit. Yeah. And then when real mob shit happens to you,
what do you expect?
Now, oh, poor me. I was just a kid. They took advantage of me. Blah, blah. No, shut the fuck up, bro.
Yeah,
no. You're a 23-year-old grown-ass man. The last time I checked, the fucking legal age to be a grown man was fucking 18. So you're well above a fucking, you know what I'm saying? Like, let's stop this kid shit. Like, no, you're a 23-year-old grown man. You know what I'm saying? You might be a fucking idiot at 23, but you're still considered a grown man. And at the end of the day, bro, like, nowadays, people just don't want to take accountability. And the people backing him, like, those are those type of people in most cases where it's like, you're just the type of person where you don't like to take accountability. You don't like to take responsibility for your fucking actions because nobody told you to hop online and send a hit.
And that's
you know what I'm saying?
That's
like,
something that people don't do is take accountability, bro. That's really good there. You know what I mean? And that was something I had to work on myself. Like,
yeah,
I feel like everybody needs to work on that. Yeah, like, you know what? Maybe I should just fucking take accountability and be like, yo, this is my fault. I shouldn't have did this. And when you do that, I notice when you do stuff like that, people look at you different.
Yeah.
And they start treating you different.
And it feels better because you, like, especially when it's true. It's like, damn, bro, like, it is my fault or whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
It feels better for you when you say that shit. Yeah. It's like, damn, bro, like, you know what I'm saying? But that just comes down to being self-aware, man.
Yep.
You got to be self-aware and you got to, like, nobody's perfect, bro. Nobody's perfect. All of us have faults. And when somebody tells you something, bro, like, a lot of the times, bro, we just have the ego. Is that ego in us where it's like we get defensive? And instead of taking in the information, we start looking for things to attack them on.
And be like, oh, well, you did that.
Yeah, it's like, you yeah, I did that, but you do this. And it's like, well, that's not the fucking point. Yeah. The point is you did that and that was wrong.
Yeah, exactly.
This yeah, is a that's whole, wrong too. Yeah. Two wrongs don't make a
but
right.
That's a whole other situation.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, exactly. It's like just taking the information, and sometimes it might make you angry in the moment. Where you're like, damn, bro, like, who the fuck this person think they are? What the fuck? Look at what they do.
Yeah.
But just shut the fuck up. Sit back and think about the situation and really be like, damn, bro, maybe I was being an asshole. Or maybe, you know, I wasn't being sensitive to their situation. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, just sit back and be self-aware, bro.
Yeah.
That's really what it comes down to.
A lot
to.
Of people need to wake up. Start doing that, man. Your life will change. Yeah, I'm telling you.
Hey, bro, we're a work in progress. Nobody's ever perfect and we never know everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, we're going to learn shit and see shit until the day we die. You know what I mean? So it's like, we're everybody's a work in progress. Don't beat yourself up about it. But if somebody brings it up, take it into account. Especially if it's somebody that's with you and they're your friend and they actually care about you. If it's coming from somebody that don't know you, fuck them. Because they don't know you.
Yeah, they don't know you. But
if it's somebody that's like, yo, bro, they're around you, you know, a lot of the times and they've been around you for years. It's like, bro, if they're telling you something, bro, it's for a reason. You know what I mean? Like, listen to what the fuck they got to say.
Yeah. That's so true, man. So true. Life is crazy. Take accountability, guys.
Take accountability, guys. But listen,
that's key of the
day. We appreciate everybody that's rocking, liking, sharing, subscribing. Don't forget, go down in the description, get yourself some merch if you haven't done so already. We got all types of flavors, all types of colors. You know what I'm saying? So go down and get yourself something. And yeah, man, we appreciate y'all. Don't forget to tell somebody you love them. And Patreon's coming soon. Peace and love. Peace and love. Peace and love.